Hello, my friends. Just something a little different from my usual stuff. Me and the camera girl, or the camera girl and I, found this place when we were driving along from another outing. And yeah, we thought we'd pop in, and the very kind owner of the car lot, yeah, said we could film. That's very nice of him. So while I was having a chat with the owner, the camera girl got to work. And here's what we... This is inside the office. He's got a lot of sort of memorabilia. Elvis, cars, of course. Yeah, you can see for yourself. Yeah, so if you don't like vintage cars, you may as well stop the video now. But this, you know, sometimes I do like to do stuff that like this because I do like vintage cars myself, and I know there's quite a lot of you out there that like them as well. So I couldn't drive past this place. Just caught my eye. Hope you enjoy it anyway. Oh, I had a vintage toy car like that, a blue one, and I gave it away. I think they were made in Germany, in the US zone, in the late 40s, 50s after the Second World War. Old gramophone, of course. Now this is a vintage MG, and looks to be from the 1970s. Inside are the European cars, and outside are the vintage US muscle cars, which we'll get to. Nice clean motor. I must say he's done a nice job. They're all very clean, nicely restored. I think some of them are actually even in the original condition, which is amazing. And this looks definitely like an Alfa Romeo, just from the shape at the front. And there it is, on the motif is on the engine block there. What do you think that is out there? Is that a spider? An alpha spider? I'm not that cluey on the alphas. Nice car though. I forgot what this is. Is it a Triumph? I could be totally wrong, and probably will be. I'm still clueless. Hopefully she goes to the back so we can see the emblem. No. She didn't go to the back, so if any of you out there know what that is, please let me know, because I have forgotten. Okay, here we are outside with some of the muscle cars, the US muscle cars. The brave camera girl is out in the rain. Her name is Sylvia, by the way, so thank you, Sylvia, for being out in the rain while I was inside. Very kind of you. Got some lovely cars. Lovely cars. I mean, look at the size of this Plymouth. I mean, it's like a ship, isn't it? It is like a ship. Now, I think he told me, the owner, this is quite rare. It's a Road Runner, but it's a rare manual. So, yeah, stick shift. But we'll take a closer look at that soon. Nice 50s Buick. Really nice cars. Sign on the window says verkauft, and that means it's been sold. So some lucky person will be taking delivery of this beautiful car soon. Now here we are, we're getting a closer look at the Road Runner. Just really, really nice lines on this car. He said it's got the original horn in it too. Spotless interior. And there you see the manual stick shift. You know, the price of petrol or gas, as my US cousins say, is pretty expensive here in Switzerland. So somebody's going to have a good wage coming in to run this car. Look at that. Really, really nice. It's almost too nice to drive, but you would have to, wouldn't you? You'd have to take this baby out on the road. I forgot what this is. It's large. I do know that. Camera girl wasn't that interested, but she likes this one better, the Javelin. Anyway, it's coming to the end of the film sequence now, and at the end of this, I'm just going to put up some stills of the cars. If you want to see that, if you're not interested, then just click off. Well, anyway, something different. Hope you motorheads out there enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. See you next time.